I've got some questions for you regarding the rapture. I've written 5 questions down that I'm going to ask you, and we are going to find them out together from the Bible. I have my beautiful King James Bible here. Beautiful King James Bible from Cambridge. There's the Cambridge seal. The epistle dedicatory. 5 questions regarding the rapture. I will first read them and then we will go through them one by one. How many trumpets are there? How many last trumps can there be? How many resurrections are there? How many first resurrections can there be? And 5, how many raptures or catching ups can there be? And then we will find out when this rapture will happen. Absolutely for sure, not my opinion, but the Bible's evident teaching. I believe the Bible only teaches one thing. When you find the truth, you throw the error out, you throw every lie out, and you hold on to the truth. Because you love the truth. A true Christian cannot but love the truth. That's what the Bible says about the falling away, about the great apostasy. It's because they did not receive the love of the truth. Let's read that. It is Second Thessalonians chapter 2, about the coming of the Antichrist, from verse 9. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth that they might be saved. When you stand in the truth and you know that it's the truth that you have believed, then you can stand strong. How many trumpets will there be? Because we read in 1 Thessalonians 4, 13 to 18, that there will sound a trumpet. If we read that in 1 Thessalonians 4, from 13, but I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. We which are alive at the coming of the Lord shall not prevent. That means come before. We will not come before them which are asleep. They which are dead will be raised up before we are caught up. It says here in verse 16, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore comfort one another with these words. A trump will sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive, the resurrection will be first. Then we which are alive shall be caught up together with them, together with them. So the resurrection is first. The rapture will not be first. The resurrection is first, then the rapture. But then we go simultaneously up to be with the Lord. Now then, if we go to 1 Corinthians 15, we're just laying the groundwork here. And it is irrefutable. Irrefutable. 1 Corinthians 15, 51 to 52. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep. Sleep there means die and lay in the ground. But we shall all be changed. That means this mortal body shall be changed into incorruptible. It shall be, we shall put on a glorified body. That's what it means. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. At the last trump. So it's the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. The last trump. What trumpets are these? Well, the book of Revelation tells us. It's the last trump. Revelation 8, chapter 2. Chapter 8, verse 2. And I saw the seven angels which stood before God, and to them were given seven trumpets. So it's seven angels with seven trumpets. Not six, not eight, not nine, not seven and a half. There's no such thing in the Bible. It's seven trumpets. When the seventh trumpet will sound, that's when the rapture will happen. And now Revelation 8 verse 6. And the seven angels which had the seven trumpets prepared themselves to sound. It's seven trumpets, that's for sure. So how many trumpets? Seven. And we read in, we've just read 1 Corinthians 15, 51 to 52, that it will, the resurrection and will happen at the last trump. So it's at the seventh trump. 1 Corinthians 15, again, 51 to 52. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. We, that's the Christians, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. And the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Yeah, so let's try and read the last trump, shall we? We find it in the book of Revelation. It is chapter 11, verse 15. What happens at the last trump? What happens there? Revelation 11, 15. And the seventh angel sounded. The seventh angel sounded. This is the seventh trump. And there were great voices in heaven saying, the kingdoms of this world are become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever. That's the beginning of the millennium. That's the return of Christ, when all the kingdoms of the earth shall become his, and he shall reign forever and ever. So that's right. When the last trump happens, that's when this, the age, the dispensation of grace will end, and the millennium will start. So it's right. That's the last trump. Yeah. So, we have seen that at the last trump, the resurrection will happen. What is a trump? It means a trumpet sounding. The sounding of a trumpet is a trump. It has nothing to do with Donald Trump. No, the last trump, the last trumpet sounding, the seventh trumpet will sound. That's when the resurrection will happen. And we saw in 1 Thessalonians 13 to 18 that that we which are alive shall not prevent them which are asleep. The dead in Christ shall be raised first, then we which are alive shall be caught up together with them. So the rapture will not happen before the resurrection. Before the resurrection. I just said now before the resurrection, but one of the questions I've written is, how many resurrections are there? Well, we find that plainly in Scripture. Revelation 20 verse 5. But the rest of the dead lived not again until the 1,000 years were finished. This is the first resurrection. The you have in that verse two resurrections. But the rest of the dead lived not again until the 1,000 years were finished. That's the second resurrection. When he says this is the first resurrection, then he's talking about what has just transpired before this. Well, what did transpire before this? Well, the end of chapter 19. Christ comes on the white horse, and the armies which are in heaven with him. His name is King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and his name is also the Word of God. Yes. And his name is called the Word of God, yes. And he comes down to earth and he establishes thrones, and there's a judgment, and this old serpent, the devil, is bound for 1,000 years. That's the beginning of chapter 20. And then in verse 5 of chapter 20, it says this, and the dead and the rest of the dead lived not until the 1,000 years were finished. This is the first resurrection. So you have a first and a last. So you have two resurrections. How many first resurrections can there be? Well, we've all watched the Olympics when they are running. How many number ones can there be? There's only one. There will only be one first resurrection. That's simple. So there will only be one resurrection, one first resurrection. And we see here from Revelation 20 verse 5 that the first resurrection will be the resurrection of the righteous, of the saved, of those that sleep in Christ, as it says in 1 Thessalonians 4, they that are asleep in Christ shall rise. That's the first resurrection. The second resurrection is all those who were not asleep in Christ and whose names are not written in the Lamb's Book of Life. They will rise after the millennium. And like it says in verse 15, or verse 14 and 15 of chapter 20 of Revelation, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. There are also two deaths, you see. And whosoever was not found written in the Book of Life was cast into the lake of fire. That's the second resurrection. That resurrection is unto damnation. The first resurrection is unto eternal life. Like Jesus said in John chapter 5. John chapter 5. John chapter 5 verse 25. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear shall live. For as the Father hath life in himself, so hath he given to the Son to have life in himself, and hath given him authority to execute judgment also, because he is the Son of God, the Son of Man, sorry. Marvel not at this, for the hour is coming, in the which all that are in the graves shall hear his voice. All that are in his graves, in the graves shall hear his voice, and shall come forth, they that have done good unto the resurrection of life. That's those that are asleep in Christ. and they that have done evil unto the resurrection of damnation. That's the two resurrections in there. Yes. So how many first resurrections can there be? Only one. Only one. So how many raptures will there be? How many raptures will there be? You see, we which are alive shall not prevent them which are asleep. The first resurrection must first happen, then the rapture. So there's no rapture before the first resurrection. Well, will there be a rapture after the rapture? Of course not. You have no authority of saying that. No biblical authority. I don't know what you learn in your seminaries, but the Bible doesn't teach any such thing. So how many trumpets? 7. Revelation 8:2 and 8:6. How many last trumps can there be? Well, in 1 Corinthians 15:51-52, it says it will be at the last trump. The word the is a definite article. It means that there is only one. There is only one last trump. That's the 7th trump. When that sounds, the dead will rise and the rapture will happen. How many resurrections are there? There are 2. When will the first occur? After the return of Christ in Revelation 19. Because in chapter 20, verse 5, that's when the first resurrection happens, so that's when the rapture happens. It's not going to happen before that. It's impossible. If it would, God would be a liar, and he is not. Read Titus chapter 1, verse 2. God cannot lie, it says there. Titus 1, 2. In hope of eternal life, which God, that cannot lie, promised before the world began. God cannot lie. God has not lied. I sometimes hear people trying to fit ulterior or alternate or extra trumpets into the Bible. They get them from the book of Numbers and this gathering and this and that and the other. No, there are 7 trumpets. And at the last one, that's when the first resurrection happens, and therefore also the rapture. It's plain, very simple, if you can read and if you believe the word. Well, of course we believe the word. Of course we do. So how many raptures? 1. When? At the last trump. Which occurs first, the first resurrection or the rapture? The first resurrection occurs first. And then we which are alive will be caught up together with them. So they go flying up. When they are 5 meters up from the ground, we get caught up with them, and then we follow them and we enter into glory. We meet Christ in the air, in the clouds, as he is coming down. The rapture is probably not us being caught up to heaven, because Jesus is coming down, you see. And it says in Revelation 19 that his wife hath made herself ready. Who is his wife? That's us. That's us. Let's read Revelation 19 again. From 11, Revelation 19:11, and I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat upon him was called Faithful and True, and in righteousness he doth judge and make war. His eyes were as a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns, and he had a name written that no man knew but he himself, and he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood. And his name is called the Word of God. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nations, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, and he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God. And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And I saw an angel, yes, that's Jesus coming. Hallelujah. And it says here in Revelation 19, just before this happens, we can see in verse 7, Revelation 19, 7, let us be glad and rejoice and give honor to him, for the marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife hath made herself ready. See this? This is it. And to her was granted that she should be arrayed in fine linen, white and clean and white, for the fine linen is the righteousness of saints. And he saith unto me, write, blessed are they which are called unto the marriage supper of the Lamb. And he saith unto me, these are the true sayings of God. So, now has come the time of the marriage supper of the Lamb. And down Jesus goes from heaven with all the saints which are in heaven on white horses. The saints in heaven have not been raised. They have not got their glorified bodies. Jesus is in a resurrection body. The rest of the saints in heaven are spirits and souls. They come down to the clouds. The resurrection happens. The rapture happens, and the saints that come down from heaven must also be clothed on with flesh, so that we're all alike. It must happen that way. It must happen that way. So the resurrection and the rapture and the coming of Christ is all of us putting on immortality, putting on a glorified body, as we read in 1 Corinthians 15. And when we see Jesus, we shall be like him. It doesn't mean that we become gods. He is God, we are not. But we will have a body like unto his. Like unto his. A body that can walk through walls. A body that can be invisible. A body that can travel. A body that was raised from the dead. That has flesh and bones. Jesus said, handle me, touch me, see that a spirit hath not flesh and bones. A resurrection body has no blood. It is held alive, kept alive by the glory of God. Where is the blood of Christ? On the mercy seat in heaven. Therefore, we will not have any blood. We will not be mortal. We will not be flesh, not mortal flesh will be. Immortal flesh. 1 John 3:2. Beloved, we are now the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. We haven't seen yet what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, when shall he appear? Revelation 19. We shall be like him. That is, we shall have a body like unto his. For we shall see him as he is. We wouldn't be able to live in a body with him if we didn't have a body like his. So that's why we shall be changed. We shall put on immortality. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. First Corinthians 15:39 and onwards. No. 37 and onwards. And that which thou sowest not the body that shall be, but bare grain, it may chance of wheat or of some other grain. But God giveth it a body as it hath pleased him, and to every seed his own body. All flesh is not the same flesh. There is one kind of flesh of man, another flesh of beasts, another of fishes, and another of birds. There are also celestial bodies, heavenly bodies, and bodies terrestrial. Terrestrial means earthly. But the glory of the celestial is one, and the glory of the terrestrial is another. Of course, the glory of the celestial is obviously greater. There's one glory of the sun, and another glory of the moon, and another glory of the stars, for one star differeth from another star in glory. So also is the resurrection of the dead. It is sown in corruption, it is raised in incorruption. What's incorruption? It's something that cannot decay, it cannot rot, it's eternal. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. It is sown a natural body. We sow our body in baptism unto Christ. And we live our lives not for ourselves, but for the glory of Christ. That is the sowing of our body. We live and die in faith in Jesus Christ. It is sown a natural body, it is raised a spiritual body. There is a natural body and there is a spiritual body. And so it is written, the first man, Adam, was made a living soul, the last Adam was made a quickening spirit. Howbeit, that was not first which is spiritual, but that which is natural, and afterward that which is spiritual. The first man is of the earth, earthy, the second man is the Lord from heaven. And then we read this, oh, I love these verses here. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed, all of us. Also those who have gone ahead into glory, they haven't been raised yet because the first resurrection hasn't happened yet. So it will all happen at the trump. The dead in Christ shall be raised, and they shall put on their bodies. We read about this also in Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8. Where is it? Yes. Romans 8. From 18, Romans 8 from 18. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. Sufferings of this present time are not worthy to compare with the glory that shall be revealed in us. In us. It's already in us, the Spirit of Christ. Christ in us, the hope of glory. Christ in us, the hope of glory. Is Christ in you? Have you been born again? Are you truly in Christ today? Are you on the vine? Are you bearing fruit? Or are you dead? You will be gathered together and men will burn you. So be sure you are in Christ. Be sure that the Spirit of Christ is dwelling in you. Like it says here in chapter 8, verse 9, but ye are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit, if so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. So, like it says also in the Word, that we are to examine ourselves, whether Christ be in us, whether we are in the faith, lest we be found to be reprobates. We must not be found to be reprobates, not at all. Let's read on here, verse 19. For the earnest expectation of the creature waiteth for the manifestation of the sons of God. For the creature was made subject to vanity. I'm reading still in Romans 8, verse 20 now. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who hath subjected the same in hope. Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. The resurrection is also called the regeneration. The millennium will be more than just us being immortal. There will be life from the dead for the whole world. That's what it says in Romans chapter 11. If the rejecting of them was the riches of the Gentiles, what shall the receiving of them be other than life from the dead? Romans 11:15. For if the casting away of them, that is the Jews, many of the Jewish branches, not all of them, of course, for if the casting away of them be the reconciling of the world, what shall the receiving of them be but life from the dead? Life from the dead for who? For them, of course. For if the casting away of them be the reconciling of the world, what shall the receiving of them be but life from the dead? The seventh millennium, the 1,000-year reign of Christ, it will be like a rest, a time of rest for the whole world. We will not be working. I don't know, but I hope and I believe that the conditions on earth will be comparable to Eden. It will be just glorious. Everything will be glorious. Mm-hmm. Christ will be on the earth in full glory. We will be in our glorified bodies on the earth. And none shall say, know the Lord, for everyone shall know him. And we shall teach the nations, and the word of the Lord shall proceed out of Jerusalem. Hallelujah. So, how many trumpets? Seven trumpets. How many last trumps? Well, how many last can there be? There will only be one last trump, like it says, the last trump. In 1 Corinthians 15, 51 to 52. How many resurrections? Two. The first and the last. The first is the resurrection of the those that sleep in Christ, followed by the rapture. The second resurrection is the resurrection of the damned. They are in hell now, they will be raised, and since their name is not found in the Lamb's Book of Life, they will be thrown into the lake of fire. That's what we saw in chapter 20 of Revelation, verse 15. How many first resurrections are there? There can only be one. In Revelation chapter 20, in verse 5, we saw that this is the first resurrection. That's when Christ has just returned to earth. Then the resurrection happens, of course. So how many raptures or catchings up can there be? Only one. It will be simultaneous almost with the first resurrection. You know I'm right. You know I'm telling you the truth. The number of raptures has to be the same number as the first resurrection. One. So, there are seven trumpets and only one last trump. And at the last trump, the dead are raised and the rapture happens. We know that. Do you follow? I'm sure you do. Now let's read Matthew 24. What is happening here in Matthew 24? From verse 29. Matthew 24 from verse 29. Immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heavens shall be shaken. Then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven. Sounds like Revelation 19, doesn't it? He comes riding on a horse, all the saints with him. It's not a secret thing, it's a big event. Then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. They're seeing him coming, you see. And they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet. There's a trumpet. What trumpet is that? Is this some other trumpet? Or is this maybe trumpet 7.5? Or trumpet 8? Or is this trumpet 6? Surely not. We know what the sixth trumpet is. It's the war that's just about ready to get started down in Syria and Turkey with Russia and everything. That's the sixth trumpet. That will be followed by the return of Christ, which will happen after the tribulation. That's what it says here. Immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened. Well, which trumpet is the return of Christ? It is the last trump. And that will surely happen in the end. Then shall appear the sign of the... Yeah. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet. And they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. What is that? They shall gather them together. That is the rapture, the catching up. It will be the Lord coming down with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, which is the last trump. We saw that in 1 Corinthians 15. That's the last trump is the resurrection. And the rapture is simultaneous with the first resurrection. It's nice to understand these things, isn't it? So forget all about pre, mid or post tribulation. It's post first resurrection. And that's post everything. That's post-tribulation, surely. So you will lose your head, or you will hide. Whatever, just let it come. Don't do like these stupid Americans, carry guns and get ready to shoot. Don't you be a murderer on the day of judgment. No, don't do that. Be murdered. Don't be a stupid or even more stupid than Peter. Peter chopped the ear off of a person. He didn't kill him. Don't you be a murderer. But if some heathen Arabs come and try to rape your wife, then maybe take your gun and shoot him in the leg or something. But don't you be a murderer. I'm referring to ISIS and all that devilish rubbish. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. The trump, with the sound of a trumpet, that's the last trumpet. That's the gathering together. See, we've always thought that the Lord shall come down and he will rapture us. Well, he uses the angels to do it. That's to say that one angel will probably come down and carry every one of us up. I believe that I have an angel. Well, the first church knew that. When Peter was in jail and he was knocking at the door and a girl called Rhoda went out to see who it was, they said, it is his angel. Guardian angels are not Catholic mysticism. I have an angel. If you're born again, you have an angel. And how I can prove that? Don't you know your Bible? It really surprises me that some people don't even believe in angels and don't know that they have a guardian angel. I have a guardian angel. I've seen my one a couple of times. I've even spoken to him a couple of times. And we won't go further into that. You'll just call me crazy. You can call me crazy anyway. I couldn't care less. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 13 and 14. But to which of the angels said he at any time, sit on my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool? Are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation? How many angels does God have? Ten thousands of ten thousands. He has millions. And they knew, the early church knew, oh, that's his angel. His angel. So Peter had an angel, which was his angel. Well, if Peter had an angel, then John had one too. If they had one, then I have one too. If I have one, you have one too. Don't need to talk to him. You don't need to seek to see him or anything. But if you see him, you will know. But don't fall down at his feet and worship him. Worship God. Hallelujah. How many trumpets? Seven. How many last trumps? One. How many resurrections? Two. How many first resurrections can there be? Only one. So how many raptures? Only one. When is the rapture? It follows the first resurrection. When is the first resurrection? After the return of Christ in Revelation 19. So it looks like in Revelation that we're going through everything. Everything. And so there's a trump. And in Matthew 24, we see after the tribulation, Christ will come and they will sound a trump. And he will gather his elect. That is the rapture. The gathering is the rapture. The gathering in. He will gather unto himself. Unto himself. Gathering unto himself. It says that in 1 Thessalonians. Uh, Second Thessalonians. 2 Thessalonians 2, verse 1. Now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by our gathering together unto him, that he shall gather his elect from the four winds. That's the gathering. What is the gathering unto him? He shall come and gather, or we will be flying up, up to be with him. How can we go flying up? Well, an angel comes down and picks you up. Just you. Yeah. The angel will carry your body. But who quickened Christ from the dead? That wasn't an angel. That was the Holy Ghost. So we will be quickened by the Holy Ghost and carried by an angel. There's nothing wrong with that. You can say, oh, I believe we'll be carried by the Holy Spirit. So be it. I have no quarrels with that. Romans 8:11. But if the Spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit that dwelleth in you. So, when we will be raised from the dead, he's quickening our bodies now, but if we die before the rapture, just like it was with Christ, the Holy Spirit quickened Christ from the dead. He that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you. He will raise up from the dead. But scripture teaches that we will be caught up by angels, carried up by angels. That's what it says about Lazarus. The angels carried him into Abraham's bosom. Angels. So that's totally biblical. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We can be excited no matter what happens. No matter what. We can be excited. We're going to see the Lord in some time, some years, 7 or 8 years, 10, 20, I don't know, I have no idea. It doesn't matter. I just know my life is flying away. I'm already 44. And if I think 10 years back, if I think 2006, 2005, it's just like yesterday. 10 years have flown, 15 years have flown. So I would say if Jesus is coming back in 15 years, it's a short time. It's nothing. Yeah. Quickened by the Holy Spirit, carried up by angels into the bosom of Jesus, and then coming down with him, and he will give us authority. Judgment will be set, and the apostles and others will be given authority to judge Israel, the 12 tribes, and so forth and so on. And we in our resurrected body will be given authority over one city, two cities, five cities, 10 cities. Yep. Where was I going? 1 Peter 3:18. For Christ also hath once suffered for sins, the just for the unjust, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but quickened by the Spirit. He was quickened by the Spirit. We will also be. Yes, we will also be. at the return of Christ, at the last trump, which coincides with the rapture, there will be one first resurrection. There will only be one rapture, and that time, the time of the rapture, is absolutely fixed. It won't be before the last trump. It won't be before the rapture. And we also know that it will not be before the great falling away, and it will not be before the man of sin is revealed, the last Antichrist, who will sit in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. It won't be before that. That's for sure. That's when the tribulation starts, or the last 7 years. And then the last 3.5 years are the years of great tribulation. And it looks like, it really looks like, it will be after the tribulation. That's when the trump will sound. We can't be inventing more trumps than what the word of God is giving us. There are seven trumps. Christ returns at the last one. There won't be a trump at the rapture and another one at the resurrection. There won't be a rapture and a gathering and a main resurrection and other little resurrections. No, there will be one resurrection, one rapture, at the last trump. The last trump. That's when it will happen. At the coming of Christ, when his bride his wife hath made herself ready, that's when it will happen. It's an event. It is one event. It is the coming of Christ. Let's see. Let's see. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 again. 2 Thessalonians 2. Now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and by our gathering together unto him, by the angels, that ye be not soon shaken in mind or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter as from us, as that the day of Christ is at hand. Let no one deceive you that there will be a pre-tribulation rapture. And then when it doesn't happen, ISIS is coming. So be it. So be it. Forget about your guns. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first. That day shall not come except there come a falling. That's a definite. That is. We can't say, oh, there was a falling away then and another one. And no, there's one last. There's one falling away. This means the last great apostasy. In the Laodicean church age, which we are living in now, which is lukewarm, half of the church will be left behind. Let no one tell you that the rapture can't happen yet because the church isn't ready. Jesus isn't waiting for all his church to be ready. He will come anytime. He will come at the time that is appointed. Whether you're ready or not, it's your job to be ready. That is if you're a wise virgin with oil in your lamp, but also in your can. Is it can or what is it called in wait a minute, Matthew 25. The wise virgins had oil in their lamps, but also in their vessels. You see, a lamp has oil in it, or it can't burn. And the foolish virgins, they also had lamps, and their lights were burning also. Because it says, our lamps are gone out. Nothing can go out except it burn first. So the foolish, they were saved, but they were foolish. In good times, they did not lay aside, they didn't pray, they didn't read their Bible, they were not doers of the word, they didn't press in to the presence of the Lord, they didn't walk with the Lord. And when the bridegroom tarried, they all slept. And then when the shout came, what's that shout? Ye shall come down with a shout, the voice of the archangel. That's the coming of Jesus. That's Revelation 19. That's when it is. It can't be before. Because the last trump fixes it. It's fixed. It won't be before the last trump. Because the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we which are alive shall be caught up together with them. 1 Thessalonians 4:13 to 18. These things are very fixed. If you compare scripture with scripture, there's only one way it can be. Post-tribulation rapture. Post-first resurrection rapture. Matthew 24 says it will be after immediately after the tribulation. Let's go back here to 2 Thessalonians 2 from verse 1. Now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and by our gathering together unto him, that ye be not soon shaken in mind or be troubled, neither by spirit nor by word nor by letter as from us, as that the day of Christ is at hand. The Thessalonians were expecting Christ at any moment. Many of them had stopped working. Many of them had possibly forbeared to plant crops. You know, Jesus is coming. They were lazy. It stopped working. Don't be like that. Live for Christ every day. Live as if you could die at any time. That's the truth for every one of us. We can all die at any time. We can get a heart attack. Anything can happen. We can be shot or run over by a car and go into eternity. Are you ready? We must be ready every day. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first. That fixes it also. There will be a falling away. That's what's happening now. Apostasy all over the world. Except where there's tribulation. So may the Lord send us tribulation. And we'll find out who's on board and who's not. Except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. Is he revealed yet? I don't think so. Who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Yes. The rapture won't happen before the last 7 years. We know that from here. The rapture won't happen before the last trump. The last trump. Come on. Where are we in the trumpets? The fifth, if you ask me, I have this from Irvin Baxter. I don't agree with everything in his theology. But he has this very right. He says that the fifth trumpet has sounded. The next one on the calendar is number 6 and then number 7. The next trump is World War III. And then the 7th trump. The resurrection and the rapture. Praise God. Amen, amen, amen.